Hi, Hein, DIY Van here. Actually working in my garage tonight, working some late hours. And what I wanted to show tonight is how I put together the shore power breaker boxes that we make for people. I've had a number of people want to make these themselves. So I just kind of wanted to show what goes on inside of the box. So here's all the parts that we would make. I got one that's pretty much almost done here that I will show you a little more details on. But we've got our Cantex box. I don't know the part number on that, but it's on our site. I got my red LED, my green LED. I got my breaker and the plate that we manufacture. I got crimp terminals, some screws. Anyway, those are all the parts. I got a diagram, which I like to keep that handy when I'm building these up. So one of the first steps I want to show you is how to put these LEDs in the plate, because it's a little bit, they're a press fit. I always like to label the red and the green. So if you look at the diagram, it shows it from the back. So, and it shows where the red and the red goes on the left side looking at the back of the plate. So all I'm going to do is, you know, make sure you get the right holes. There's a lot of holes here. These four holes are for holding the breaker, but these top holes that are not countersunk, those are for putting the LEDs in. So my red light is going to go on this side, on the left side, as I'm looking at the back of the plate. And so you just kind of pull the wires through. And then this little white guy is a little sleeve that actually goes between the two poles of the breaker. So it installs with the pins and a couple of E-clips. But what you can do is use that to push the LED in. So you're just going to put the lens of the LED on. You're going to lay this on the table, put the LED lens in there, and then push. Push the LED through. I need to start it just a little bit here. Anyway, then you can just push. I'm not going to be able to do it here without watching really close. There we go. Here we go. So just using the little spacer to go around the lens is allowing me to push that LED through. So that's really just an easy step on how to get that done. And then that's obviously used here as well. So the first step is to put those two LEDs in, which I've already done. Now the other thing I like to do, as these breakers, they obviously are going to have a neutral side and a hot side, and then they have a load side and a line side. So I like to write that on the actual breaker. So I've got this one pretty much put together. So I've got load side written on here. I've got line side written on the other side. I've got hot and neutral. That just allows me to just make sure visually that I'm putting this together correctly. I've also, this is a 30 amp breaker box, so I got 10 gauge Ancor wire here. I've also labeled the two leads that are coming out of the box, line and load. So that can keep everything, keep track of everything so I get it wired up though. On these boxes, and these are made for conduit obviously, and for the 10 gauge wire to fit through that hole, I need to enlarge, this is for half inch conduit, so this is the box that we use. But you can see where I enlarged the hole in the box itself so that these two wires can pass through there once I get to putting this together. So one of the things you want to notice here is exactly how I have these wires arranged. There's a lot of things that have to fit in this box, and it only really fits one way. Now, the leads that come from the LEDs, what I've done is I've crimped those into the same leads that I'm using for the actual load and line side wires. So I'll take one of these crimp connectors, and you can see here where I've got the little wire that comes from the LED in the same sleeve with the main wire, and then I crimp those. These are double crimp Ancor wires. I'm using their Ancor tool. I've got these really nice wire strippers that work really good. I'm stripping about 4 inches of insulation or sleeving away from the wire. And so that's allowing me to route this. Now the final step on putting this together is, because this all has to fit in the box, this green ground wire is gonna kind of lay right in between the two breakers. So what I do is, and I've already put this all together, I'm just gonna show you this little trick I do with cloth electrical tape. Because I've done this crimp, I've actually soldered this one as well. That's a crimp lug, but it's not insulated. So I'm gonna wrap it with some cloth electrical tape I like to put it over the ends as well. Get it good and wrapped. And I'm gonna do this also over here where it's gonna pass between these terminals on the breaker, because I wanna have some added protection of these wires so that they don't chafe against these terminals over time. So I'm just gonna do the end right now and show you how that works, but I will also wrap cloth electrical tape along this whole length. And then what I've got here is some super thin super glue, or it's cyanoacrylate glue. It's not super glue, but it's much better. It's from Bob Smith Industries. The nice thing about it is it'll saturate this cloth electrical tape. So it's basically soaking in. As you can see there, it's soaking in. And that's gonna cure up. In fact, it might even smoke a little bit because that's curing that super glue. It puts off some heat when it cures. But what this is gonna do is it turns this electrical tape into a hard mass. So you could never pull it off of there. It won't unravel, and it's gotten hard like a plastic cover. So that's a really good way to protect that last terminal, that's the ground. And then I'm gonna wrap some more around here where I can protect that. So all that's gotta go in the box, and it's gotta go underneath this in between there. Now, one of the other things that I do with my box is, because we're not using, this is an original box that's unmodified, I'm cutting this post out. And that just gives me some more room up here for this ground connector to go up here. So all I've done is basically sawn that rib out, and then I've taken my cutters and just cut that out. Because we're only gonna use these four to attach the plate once I got it put together. So once I'm done with this, what I'll do is I'll feed the ends of these wires in through here and then put the plate in, and then we supply screws to attach the plate to the box. So just take a good look at how that's done. I'll rotate it around a little bit. You can see where all my wires are, how they're routed. Make sure you get your screws good and tight. And so this is, once I put this extra tape on here in this area to protect this a little bit more, this will be ready to feed into the box and screw it in, and it'll be ready to go. Now, one thing I do as well is I've got a plug with some wire nuts on it. I'm gonna purposely wire this up with the reversed polarity so that I can test that the red light comes on, and then I'll also connect it with the correct connection to make sure the green light comes on when I turn it on and off. So I test every one of these so that I know that the LEDs are been hooked up correctly. Now these LEDs, if you notice, this one's got a green and a white wire on it, and that's the red one. So that's gonna go with the neutral side to the ground on the load side. And then the red, or the green one, it has a black and a white wire on it. So it goes between the neutral and the hot on the load side. So this one goes on the line side, so that if you have the reverse polarity, that red light's gonna come on regardless of whether or not you have the breaker thrown to on. And then this one goes on the load side so that the green light comes on to tell you that the downstream load line is activated or energized. Okay, so that pretty much sums it up. If you have any further questions, reach out to us. I really recommend that we put these together, but if you feel up to it, that's how you put it together yourself. Thank you very much.